Hello, North Andover Middle School. This is one of four videos you will be watching today. This video focuses on our safe return, schedules, classroom setup, hallway use, and bathroom use information and protocols. Without further ado, let us begin. You will be watching a video from our nurses with detailed information. I do want to highlight some of those important mitigation strategies that you have done an amazing job employing this entire year. I just want to review a few of those again with you today. First and foremost, a safe return to in-person school environments will require a culture of health and safety every step of the way. Students, with the assistance of your families, you must be monitored daily for symptoms. Students must stay home if feeling unwell. There is a number to call the nurse in the daily emails you receive if you have any questions or you're not sure whether or not you can come to school. Also, masks. We need to keep wearing them. Even though many of our staffs are fully vaccinated, we still have to wear our masks. Everyone must embark on this culture of mask wearing. Masks must completely cover your nose and mouth and fit snugly against the sides of your face without any gaps. Hand hygiene continues to be critical. You're required to exercise hand hygiene, that's hand washing or sanitizing, upon arrival to school, before eating, before putting on and taking off masks, and before dismissal. Hand washing with soap and water for at least 20 seconds is the best practice. However, hand sanitizer should be substituted when hand washing is not available. Also, you'll notice we have assigned seats in all of our classes. Our teachers have assigned seats for our students. They have seating charts that are dated. If there's ever a change made to a seating arrangement in a class, the teachers keep a copy of all past and current seating charts. Physical distance greatly reduces the risk of transmission. Therefore, students will be at least 3 feet from one another in classrooms and 6 feet away during mask breaks or when eating. Now, there has been a recent change. Close contacts who were exposed to a COVID-19 positive individual in the classroom or on the bus while both individuals were masked do not have to quarantine unless they were within 3 feet distance of the COVID-19 positive individual for a total of 15 minutes during a 24-hour period. We were prepared to have to quarantine many students if anyone were to be positive here at NAMS. Although we've had very few positive cases at NAMS, the good news is because our students will be separated by 3 feet in all classes at least, and 6 feet when you're eating or drinking or taking a mask break, we really should not be in a position where students are being quarantined. I do want to, first and foremost, before I continue this presentation, just thank our nurses, Mrs. Pease and Mrs. Wolf. They have done an absolutely amazing job this year, and I just wanted to recognize and appreciate them for everything they've done. All right, now let's go over those schedules. So our schedules effective Wednesday will change slightly. So what's in yellow applies to in-person students. So 7:30 to 7:50 is when students are arriving. Students will actually be let off the buses at 7:20, and we will ask our students to remain either outside the cafeteria, outside the main doors, or outside of Sims lobby until 7:30, when you'll be allowed to enter the building. You then go to homeroom. Homeroom begins at 7:50 on the dot, and that's when morning announcements and attendance will be taken, and that's when teachers also verify that you have ordered lunch and snack for the day. Then sixth graders, you have three academic classes, and then the fourth academic class, you'll notice it has 25 more minutes than the other classes. That's because that's when snack time takes place. And on your team, all teams will eat snack together at the same time. And that'll happen either at the beginning, middle, or end of the class. Sixth graders, you end the day with two related arts. Then you go back to homeroom. In homeroom, we only have 5 minutes. We have our lunch bags delivered to homeroom. Actually, a student or two will be picking those up. And we want to make sure we distribute lunches to students. And then you're dismissed at 1:55. Now, the OLA student schedule begins at 7:50 and ends at 1:50. you wouldn't have to go to this student arrival, student dismissal, and the end of the day homeroom. That doesn't really apply to you. So from 7:50 until 1:50, that is your school day. In grade 7, you'll see much the same thing. Student arrival, student dismissal, homeroom is the same, but our schedule changes slightly for 7th graders. They'll have two related arts, and then they'll have all five of their academics. And their third academic is when snack time takes place. And again, snack time will happen at the beginning, middle, or end. And that has been identified for each of the teams. And after a couple weeks, we can switch the times. Grade 8, very similar again. Three academics, two related arts, and then two more academics. And this academic 4 from 12 to 105, that is when 8th graders will have snack, either beginning, middle, or end of the period. Moving on, these are some 6th grade classrooms. You might be sitting in this room right now. These are 6th grade classrooms. You'll notice that the chairs have been set up. Although seat edge to seat edge has to be a minimum of 3 feet, in any classroom in which we have more room, we've spread out the desks even more. So even though the minimum distance is 3 feet, you'll notice these two grade six classrooms, based on a number of students who will be scheduled into these classes, we were able to spread the desks out even more. Students at the diagonals, you are at least, you're actually more than 6 feet away from each other. So on inclement weather days where students can't go outside for snack, some students will be eating in the classroom at times. The good news is the students at the diagonals will be 6 feet away. And then students on the sides, those students will either be sitting in the hall doing some work, or will be going to other locations as well. But we want our students to go outside as much as possible for snacks. Hallway use, just a reminder, we always stay to the right. Remember that when you first start driving here in America, we drive on the right side of the road. We also walk on the right side of the halls. And you'll notice these signs are all over the building where you stay to the right when you're walking down the halls. We've also labeled many areas of our building, especially entrances and exits. This is the auditorium. We want our students to enter through one set of doors and exit through the other set of doors. This minimizes the need for students to cross paths as they're entering doorways. Stairwells are also up or down stairwells. To help you out in the hallways, you'll notice taped to the top right of the corridor, you'll notice up stairwell this way. If you're walking this way, you're going the right way if you want to go up the stairs. If you're walking this way and you see down stairwell, you know you have to turn around because the up stairwell's the other way. And then once you get to the stairwell, you'll also see signs letting you know, yep, you can go up those stairs. This is in 7th grade, this is in 8th grade, very similar signs. Then you'll see the down stairwell. So if you're walking down this hall and you need to go upstairs, you know you need to turn around because the down stairwell is actually this way. And if you got to those stairs, you would see signs for do not enter one way. You're not to go up those stairwells. It's the other stairwell you want to use. And here's just another picture. This is an 8th grade carrier wing. Again, you'll see plenty of signs letting you know if you can go up those stairs or not. Bathroom use, because we've had half the number of students in school most of the year, we really haven't had any issues with too many students needing to use the bathroom at the same time. However, with the number of students attending school almost doubling, we anticipate that we will need to closely monitor students' numbers in the bathroom. So what you'll see is, we have a bathroom capacity signs outside every bathroom. This is the Sims lobby. We have three students and three students who can go into the girls' or boys' restroom. This is in carrier wing. Again, it's 3 is the maximum occupancy. And if that number is met, then we have places for students to stand outside the bathroom. We also will have staff most often here sitting outside the bathrooms, just making sure that we don't exceed the occupancy of students in the bathroom. And something else I wanted to show you is, what we try to do with our bathroom doors when appropriate is we'll actually leave them ajar like this. What this allows is for a student to enter the bathroom without having to touch the door or the wall. And also you can see if someone's coming out. So it's not one person's trying to get out as another person's trying to get in. We're trying to minimize any contact with other students. Also, there's hand sanitizer locations all over the building, and we went one step further and actually labeled them. I'm sure you've seen them already if you've been attending school in person, but I just wanted to remind you of that. They are everywhere, all over the building. Cafeteria spaces, they look different. We set up the cafeteria, the eighth grade cafeteria, a little differently right before break. So you're probably used to seeing this. We've set up all the tables 6 feet apart. So on those inclement weather days, we can actually fit three classes safely in the eighth grade cafeteria. And there are those lunch bags that students will pick up for snacks and for lunch to be distributed at the end of the day. And this is the seventh grade side of the cafeteria. We ran out of those white 3x3 foot tables, but we did have plenty of extra desks that we ordered, so we were able to set these up as well. And as you can see, there's the lunch bags. Lunch bags will be located on each side of the caf, and we have enough seating for three classes as well for those inclement weather days. We also have the ability to, when we do go outside for snacks, we've identified many locations around the building. These are three, not only locations for snacks, but also locations for classes that can be used in the courtyard of the school. This is prime real estate because Wi-Fi will actually work in the courtyard. And we have one tent set up. It's a 20 by 40 foot tent. And then over here is another tent. And then across from here are the benches with Adirondack chairs. All students have been or will be issued a yoga mat and a clipboard for when we do go outside or your class is taken outside. You have what you need to either sit and or to write. We also have a tent that was set up right in front of the carrier wing, and we also still have the two music tents. Teachers are able to sign up for these outside spaces, the spaces with tents and the student benches, if they would like to take their classes outside. There are other locations that students can go outside as well. These are first come, first serve and don't have to be reserved, but we did want to reserve the tented areas for staff and students. And that is the NAMS classroom setup, hallway use and bathroom use informations and protocols. Thank you for watching. And again, this is one of four videos you'll be watching today. Be well, everyone.